and welcome to our channel. I just want to give you guys a quick rundown on how we're going to do Vlogmas. Vlogtober, I can't do this every day. So what I'm going to do is we'll vlog a little bits here and there throughout the day. And then I'll put it together and we'll just do a week compilation. You know something? I work. I go to school. I got a lot of stuff going on. And it's the holidays. And I got a lot of stuff going on. And I just don't have the time to vlog all day, every day. I just, unfortunately, like, that's life. And that's the life I've chosen. I have chosen to continue my education and work while being a YouTuber. Yeah. I am going to vlog as much as I can today. We'll put a vlog miss day one. And then after that, it will be a weekly kind of event. So, yeah. I guess follow me around, not doing anything too exciting today. Alright, well, welcome to Vlogmas day two. I actually, didn't end up recording anything else yesterday because nothing happened. But tonight I am going, Jesus, nice lights. I am going to go shopping for our local pet food pantry. So some places just have food pantries, but where I am, they have it set up that if you, you know, can't afford to feed your animal or you need help, you know, people fall on hard times, there's a place you can go and get food and supplies for your pet. So I am gonna go and get a bunch of stuff to donate. I got lucky. I got a bunch of free coupons from Priyuna, however you say it. So I'm gonna use that. Axel does not eat that food, so he's got tummy issues. So, yeah, I'm going to go do that now, and I will bring you guys along for that. I actually think I'm going to do a separate video for that, because I just want to show people that there's other ways of giving than just to humans. For me, during the holidays, there's three categories I give to. Animals, the elderly, and small children. So that's where everything goes. We kind of have a tradition that we don't really give gifts to adults unless they are, you know, family. It's just kind of our thing. You know, we just give to kids. But yeah, I'm gonna drive to the store right now and we'll get started on all of this. Alright, so I'm at my local Target. Sorry, it's a CVS pharmacy, so I'm gonna go in. I have to actually drop off two prescriptions, and then I'm gonna go check out the nail food stuff. So exciting, I know. I always love to vlog at Target, right? So, just my luck, I just finished shopping and they're already closed. Alright, so this is everything I ended up getting for the donation. Two bags of dozen chips, Purina One, some kitty litter, some dog food, some candy dog food, some more treats, and stuff, so pretty decent, I'd say. So I'm gonna go check out and then went home, picked up some food for dinner. Some rigatoni with pesto and breadsticks and drinks for my husband. So, yep, I'm gonna get checked out here and head on home. So, we're dropping Axel off at daycare. This is like their decorations in front. So, Yeah, we're gonna go to the Chriskingle Market and then go pick up our Christmas tree and get that decorated. So, we'll show you guys what it's like when we get there. All right, so we are now at the Chriskingle Market. We're gonna go on in and see what they have to offer. Oh, dogs are prohibited. I think we left the Axel Daycals. Different glass ornaments. I don't know when these are from. What? You know this is an exhibit. So they have an exhibit right, this is at like a museum kind of place. So an exhibit of all the, what do you call them? Ornaments throughout the years. I am so tired. I don't even know what I'm looking at. So it's kind of cool. Very cool. All right, so here's a gingerbread man from Cuck Robin. It's a restaurant. Back in the day. They don't have those anymore, right? Cuck Robin's?
There might still be like one around here.
Ah.
They closed a few.
This is the fun part. It's pretty big. It's 15,000 feet of space. So there's a lot. We're going to look for ornaments and, I don't know, maybe some cute Christmas decor. So, yeah. Fun Christmas fun. Right?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Well, there's the Chriskingle Market, but there's also all these buildings. How old is this place?
30 years or yeah. 200, something like that.
Yeah. Do you think it's pre-Civil War?
Yeah. Probably by like 50 years or something.
Okay. So these are actual houses that were here back in Civil War. I don't know if they're actually here though, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure if they were moved because here. Some of them might be original.
I'm pretty sure this wasn't here next to this house. I mean, it just seems like it's so compacted in a small area. A lot of people actually get married here, but it's expensive.
Oh, yeah.
AF.
I think it's like, oh, it starts at 60.
Yeah, it starts at $60,000 to get married here. So this is a schoolhouse from the 1890s. That schoolhouse. And then we got a halfway house. A lot different than when we were younger, from the 1900s. So 1890. Looks. I lost my husband. All right. And there's this beautiful house. So this is the carriage house right here. And the mansion's over there, you can see. Let's go walk over here and see. Oh, that's my husband. Yeah, I don't know if I'd pay 60 grand to get married here. In our wedding anniversary vlog, I showed you guys where we got married, and it was expensive, but it wasn't 60 grand expensive. And that's just for the place to get married. That's not for everything else included. So I couldn't imagine. And our, like I said, our wedding was expensive, but not 60 grand expensive. I don't think I couldn't have a $60,000 wedding. Oh yeah. What else do we have? Alright. This is what else I have here. It's called Neighbor Settlement. Papa Post Office. It's over that way. I don't know if we'll make it over there, but let's see. I'm gonna have problems with filming again. They've got some decorations set up. And yeah, let's go to a log cabin. I don't think I've ever been here as a child, but, well, hello.
Hi.
Where did you go? I was like,
Daniel's house. It's the house of the doctor. Are you still
here? Oh, okay. I was like, I lost my husband. Let me just keep walking and looking around.
But now they are selling stuff inside.
Oh, cool.
Little knickknacks and, like, dried and saved flowers and things like that.
So you mean, should I would want, but then I would it just sit in a box, like, pretty much every other knickknack I buy?
I was looking around, I'm like, that would look like something that needs to be dusted on the shelf after about 5 days.
Is this, like, a kid's playground right here? Yeah. Okay, so this is not original. Yeah. Yeah. We can't go in either. It's locked.
It is a low fence, though. Not worth getting kicked out for.
Yeah, no. Kicked out of a free place. What are you doing?
Oh, the wagon?
Yeah. I want one of these. Yeah, I love these. These are the cars they used to have downtown, right? Or that was... It was the Elmhurst, I know, had cars downtown. I don't know if they did the cars downtown. They did the cows, right?
Yeah.
Around downtown. Yeah. So, they have a covered wagon. So, actually, I'm going to put down the camera and walk over there and then pick back up because there's children around. And I don't like putting strangers' children on the internet. So, we'll be right back. All right, here is the wagon. That can't be a legit wagon, but no. Back in the day. I don't think so. I mean, it's beat up, but I don't think it's legit. All right. Shan, what do we have over here? You know I'm tired because I keep making random sounds. This is the Neighbor Height House. From 1860.
It's probably not something weird like Hoggett or. Yeah.
So this is somebody's. Yeah, so these houses weren't here because this is built on Washington Street. So, okay, what was this originally supposed to be? Babe.
I don't know.
I know that they. It says.
Oh, it's a last name. Oh, it's a storage building.
Okay, so this used to be, so this used to be a storage building, and then they rented it out as a house, because they rented it out as a residence. Yeah, I don't know if I could live in something, it's like one of those tiny houses. I don't know what this is. Oh,
it's a church.
It's a church. Oh, wait a second, what's this loft? Let me see the loft house. This is the log house from 1830. You're like, great, I thought this was a vlog, not a freaking history lesson. Well, too bad. You get a history lesson today, too. So, that's what the interior looks like, I guess. You can't see in. That's rubbish. Why would they, why have a curtain? Come on now. Here, we'll show you a picture of the house, but we're not going to let you see inside the actual house. I think that photo is a lie. Alright. And now we have the church. The church has probably seen better days. No, this isn't a church. This is a meeting house.
What is it?
Lies. Meeting house. From 1840. Okay, maybe it was a church. Okay. What? But it's called it's a meeting house. It's the oldest church building in DuPage, but... I don't know.
This is the bathroom. It's been here 200 years.
This is the bathroom. It was original with the land. You sure it wasn't something else ever? Because it looks kind of old. I don't know. This is a bell. And this is a rain garden. It's where rain comes from. It's this garden. Right? Yeah. So, you think rain comes from the side? No, the sky? No. It comes up from this garden and goes up into the sky and then travels somewhere else. Right?
Right.
Okay. That's not how rain really works. So, yeah. So, they manage shore water by collecting rainwater runoff. So... it has the bell. We're not in New York. It says rest. Okay. Let's see. And so Andrew Mealy, West Troy, New York, 1846. So let's see. This is the firehouse. It doesn't have anything about that bell. Okay, no, it does. Yeah, this firehouse is from 1870. And then I don't know what this is. I swear I've never been here. My mother would tell you a whole different story on how I used to come here as a child and I loved it here. Just like the place I got married at, which I don't have any memory of going as a child, but whatever. Alright. So that's just a pump. Yes, that's all that sign is about, is a pump. It's not drinking water. Do not drink this water. All right, I think we're going to go back into the craziness. I'm not looking forward to it. Okay. So this is a stone carving place. And this is a print shop. So they're both from the 1880s. Alright, I think we're gonna stop here and are you gonna head into the mass, that scary mass of angry people that should be happy that it's Christmas time. Somebody told me to elbow someone, suggested that I just elbow someone and squeeze my way through. So that's what we're dealing with. Alright, we'll catch up with you guys in just a while. There's no historical signage on this, but I think this has been here from like the 1700s. Would you say? 1700, 1750? And that's when this came into play at the neighbor's helmet.
Steel and indoor plumbing.
Hey, you know something? Propane.
Had steel.
Yeah, I know. Andrew Carnegie. Hey. Duh. Alright, and this little doom buggy thingy looks like it's probably from, I would probably say, 1880s to 1890s. That's what I'm guessing. I don't know if it runs or not, but yeah. History, man. History. All right. So we left. It was pure craziness. It was at least a 15-minute wait to get into any of the ornament shops, if not longer. So we are going to go grab lunch at Portillo's. If you know of Chicago, you know of Portillo's. If and go to Michael's. Is that the plan?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're having a big sale on Christmas decor, so we're going to check them out. And then get a tree and all that fun stuff still. So, yeah, we're going to go grab lunch and then go do all that fun Christmassy stuff again. All right. This is the inside of Portillo's. It's very, very loud. But they have a truck all the way up there. So yeah, I'm just finished eating. What? So just finished eating and I think we're gonna head on over to Michael's now and get some Christmas stuff. Yeah. All right, so we found some stuff at Michael's. We're about to check out. We're getting this picture frame for my mother-in-law. And then we found this cute basket. I don't know what we're going to do with it, but it's cute and it's 50% off. Oh. And then these two pillows are $13.50. And then that. I'm gonna get Peppermint Lane and Mistletoe. And then, don't you fall on the ground, pillow. There's only those two left. Oh, this little angel ornament. And then we got, I'm going to break it. I am gonna break it. Okay. This is not working out too well. My husband's just standing here watching me struggle. I can't get to turn back around. I got it now. So we got two of these. One for Axel and the other one for Tana. And then, oh, I don't want that. Make sure I don't break the sled. And we got this one, and we'll put like a family picture in there with us, Tanner, and Axel. So, yeah, those are our finds at Michael's today. I don't think we're going to be getting our Christmas tree today because we got to go get Axel from daycare and all that jazz. So, I'll let you guys know if we do, but I don't think we're going to. So, well, like I said, we'll let you know. We woke up, and if you guys can't tell, it's snowing! I'm so excited! There's a dog park. Look at it. Oh! So excited for snow. Oh, I'm starting to feel that like Christmas now. Alright, I just made us some lunch, some penne pasta with, or not penne, it's rigatoni with chicken and pesto. I'm watching Gilmore Girls finally, so Axel hoping we drop some. Hey, what's this guy? Like, I don't care. He was playing with this earlier, our new pillows. So, Axel, I don't know if we're going to go get a tree today. It's still snowing. We might go play out there with the doggies in just a little bit. So, we're going to eat real fast, and I need to get some studying done, but then, yeah, we'll go have some snow fun. All right, so we're at the dog park now. It's not, it's still snowing. We got a lot of snow, so. Trying to let them have some fun. And they're gonna poop. All right, I'm gonna pause this so we can go clean it up and then, or maybe not, maybe. We gotta pee here. You guys, play, have fun. What are you doing, old man? Peeing again. You guys gonna play? So yeah, I don't know how much. Do you know how much snow we're supposed to get? Because it's been snowing all day. How much snow do you think we have? Six? 6 or 7 inches so far. Last winter it snowed one time, so. Nine-year-old versus two-year-old. They're like, leave me alone, Axel.
Be nice.
And we're back. Just frolicking in the snow. This is exciting, I know, but I'm going to end the vlog here. Thank you so much for watching. We're doing vlogs at least once a week, if not more, if we have an event or anything. But yeah, thank you again for watching. Take care. If you'd like, go ahead and subscribe, and we hope y'all have a great day. Take care. Bye.